Execrations turn to pick. Dire team pick.
Sound fine to me, dude.
Yeah, no, it's not that. It's on, for some reason, it's not working. Like, I have to change it when I start to OBS from now on. Anyway, all right, everybody, welcome back into the CCAP. I guess you could say tiebreakers here before we get right into the playoffs. It is a best of three series between Mineski as well as, not Navi PH, no. It's Execration. They said it was a bug. I don't know what kind of bug that is, where their name doesn't work. But that's that. We'll jump into the game. Of course, we're here on Moondeck TV. My name is Mont. Joining me today, as always, is Trent Bax. Trent, how the hell are you, buddy?
Oh, fantastic. We're getting started nice and early. These guys are ready to go.
Oh, yeah.
So that's good. About a minute ahead of time. They were just doing their thing. But yeah, no, their name is even officially Navi PH in terms of, like, in the client. And now they're showing up everywhere as Navi PH. So whatever they did, they're Navi PH for now.
Yeah, I don't know. That's, I see that on Dota Buff.
Someone hit some buttons.
Navi PH, the classic. The new squad, perhaps. But for real, it is Execration. Real quick, I just want to talk about where we are for C Kappa. You guys may have been with us with the other tiebreaker, which was for just strictly for seeding for the playoffs. And I believe it was like, I think it was Warriors Gaming Unity versus Happy Feet. And that was just strictly for seeding. I think, I can't remember who won. I think Warriors Gaming Unity won that 2-0, actually. So they get the top of the group in Group B. Happy Feet are second. So Happy Feet will play up against High Ground in a very good playoff match. Can't wait for that to happen. But what we're doing here now is we're determining who moves on from Group A. We have three teams already in the top three. And, of course, only top two move on. We have High Ground. And then this series, Mineski versus Execration, will determine the other team in that playoff spot to face up against Warriors Gaming Unity, Trent. Should be pretty interesting.
Yeah, this is you're done. Don't lose.
Yes. Exactly.
That's what it comes down to. So in terms of our draft, first overall went to the Slurder. I don't know what's going on, but lately in SEA, I don't know where the Monkey King is, but no value. No
Not
one's
here.
Digging it. Nope. Probably won't be showing up either with a Nyx Assassin and now an Axe.
Yeah, I would be surprised if that was the case for Execration. But what I've been watching a lot of DPL, they've been picking a ton of Leech Commander. Legion has shown up in a lot of pro games, and it's banned first overall here by Mineski, so apparently these teams value just as highly as those teams in DPL do, which I find pretty interesting. But why is it picked so heavily as of recently, Trent? What's the good reason? What's the good word on LC?
Yeah, I think most people are, in terms of the offlane ranking system, it's basically like Axe and Legion are super top tier, I would think, at this point. Centaur got knocked down a couple pegs just from changes, nerfs, and whatnot.
Right.
So we're basically just everyone's kind of fiddling with the offlane a little bit right now. And Legion is just so good because she has that self-purge. And it basically means that if you only have a slow or something in the lane, she's so difficult to force out. She does well against a lot of our common heroes we talk about too, like Jug or Legion Commander. Jug or Lifestealer, just because like Lifestealer is the prime example, right? Like he has open wounds, but you can just purge it off, and then it makes it difficult for the support to close using that that assistance from the Lifestealer.
Yeah, that's actually
and
a good
obviously
point.
She can jungle too and stuff, but
yeah. A lot of value you can get from Legion Commander. You get a blink early on in the game, get some duels off, and all of a sudden you're pretty good. But just for laning dominance, Legion is very good.
Yeah. She's hard to shut down. Like she's just gonna go jungle somewhere. I mean, you've all seen it in every one of your pub games, so
yeah. It's fun. It's great. But there is an Oracle pick coming out now for Execration. So we'll see Oracle, Nyx Assassin potentially is the 1-2 combination Lifestealer played
looks
in.
That way.
Yeah, that's what I'm thinking anyway. I would be surprised if they landed differently.
This is pretty cool. Dazzle fell off, I feel like, a little bit. It was super popular. And then heading into DAC, I don't think we saw too much Dazzle, at least compared to pre-DAC. So we get the Axe counter. And again, Axe just a pretty solid offlaner right now. Anyway,
right.
Now just like an Oracle. I haven't seen this guy in what feels like forever. But we can purge off some Iron Shells. We can purge off the Corrosive Haze. So some generally obnoxious things for Oracle to do this game.
Yeah, very good against Darkseer and Lane as well with the Fortune's End. Pretty good stuff. So should be a pretty good pick here for Execration. Whether or not they can get kills in lane remains to be seen. Kind of interested in seeing how this Nyx Assassin is going to be played. And then on the other side, of course, Mineski will pick up the Luna. One thing I do want to mention, of course, before we continue on here, is Minesky have had they've added some interesting people to their lineup since as of recently. Of course, we all heard out 343, aka yes. Adam, joining up, and he is now going to be the captain. It looks as if for Minesky, and then even when Warriors Gaming Youth member standing in here for Minesky. So two very good players now coming along for Minesky. It should be very interesting to see Templar how it goes assassin. For them.
Oh, we're gonna get ourselves the likely the Mushi TA. So
let's go.
Last Luna strat that they were running, they were doing the Quap. So I heard a lot of people talking about the Mushi Quap. I guess he was kind of tearing up lately. Like, so now I think twice the last couple of Luna strats they've been doing that, including an Alchemist just in their previous game for the Manila Masters too. But guys playing a lot of Luna lately. So it seems like they're valuing this hero a little bit. Not too common for everyone else, but once you get past the Lifestealer and the Jug, I guess Luna's kind of that next tier. But it's the SEA Classic.
The Tinker. It's picked up. Ready to go. Very good hero as of recently. He's been picked a lot, I feel like. He's just one of those obnoxious fifth picks that you just have to deal with, and it's not the easiest thing in the world to deal with in terms of pushing up high ground, March making it very difficult, keeping the lanes pushed out, all that good stuff.
At this point, it's pretty surprising for us to see him get picked in the fifth. It seems like almost every one of our games he's banned out.
Yep, that's very true.
Right in that last slot, so.
Not this time, though, Trent. They've gotten, they're ready to go.
Okay, so good high ground defense. Probably one of the best heroes whenever you see these kind of Luna Dazzle strats. Trying to hold the high ground for as long as possible. When they get there, you win one big fight, you can just easily catch back up thanks to Comeback Gold, it seems these days at least. So we'll have an Axe, we'll have a Tinker. But overall, they don't have the... I don't know. It's pretty good AoE damage, but it's not like crazy. Still going to take that mistake from an Esky probably where they group up or something for Axe to find that big call.
Yeah. The big team fight to come out from them. I don't know. This Nyx Assassin seems like he's one of the X factors here. I think for both of these teams. In fact, I'm not sure how it's gonna how it's gonna work in this game because it's not something we see too often in that four position. You know, it's just an interestingly picked first overall too. I guess it's a good hero, but
yeah, we'll have to see how they want to level him up and stuff. Like, how much can the Axe get? Can he stay in lane long enough to get some items going so that he can maybe make a rotation somewhere? Give Nyx the lane. Can they get some jungle stacks going from the Oracle or something that's going to help out the Axe and try and propel him and then again, therefore, give more space over to Akimuel too. So, let's find out. Nyx Assassin buys the booties, gets TP. Ward is down instantaneously with no hope of seeing that from the Dire, so good start for them. But likewise, down the bottom, smoked up Slardar. 343 will find himself the good ward down bot. Plenty of vision. No camp blocked.
Yeah, no camp blocked, which I thought was interesting for this bottom ward, but...
Yeah, I think that means they're going to go aggressive then, which, I mean, they have a Luna, so we'll see.
We'll see if that's going to be the case.
Yeah. They might just try and... I don't know.
Wind's already down here. They're probably like trying to decide, it looks like, and now they're going to head Bimbo head top, it looks
like. They were like thinking about it, and then they were like, maybe they're going to dodge and come top, but...
Are they switching this up, by the way? Like, I feel like the... Bimbo was playing the offlane, wasn't he, recently? Or, I guess with this new roster, they have Wen playing the offlane? Or, well, I don't know. Like, he might just be standing, but I'm interested to see how this is. The Bimbo, safe lane, Luna. Well, I might not even be safe lane.
Fair enough. Yeah, we'll have to find out. No one really knows where anyone's going.
No, I have actually not. I just wait until the game starts.
The beauty of a Luna draft, though. I mean, they have plenty of flexibility here with Dazzle Slardar in terms of their supports.
All right, well.
I mean, they're coming down now, but they're definitely not going to make the rune in time.
Yeah, they're not content. I think they decided too late. They kind of wanted to do that, but I think it wouldn't have gone well if they had decided for it. So instead, they'll just grab a couple of bounties for everybody. Mushi gets the one over towards this bottom lane.
Smart play by Axe, though. Mr. BYV grabs top.
Oh, did he? Yeah, Wen can't get it. So that's three of four for Excavation. So, all right, well, we'll see how it goes. Wen's already getting his creep wave cut. But the Iron Shell's up, and BYB's like, damn it. He does have eight tangos, though, so we'll keep an eye on that. But as you mentioned, Trent, it is going to be an aggressive tri lane coming out bottom. There is a good lane ward here placed by, I think, Kimuel. So just something to keep an eye on, and then we'll keep our eyes peeled on that matchup mid, see if anybody goes down early on. But I'm very interested to see how this tri lane works out. Ooh, they dropped the sentry. Get it?
Get it.
Yes. Nice. Bimbo gets himself 100 gold. He's like, let me just tango that real quick. I don't even want a chance them putting the sentry down. That would have been scary. Kimuel was not ready for that. So, lane ward, de-warded. Sentry dropped, and no. That's A little too late, unfortunately.
Yeah, I was trying to see if it was that deep observer ward down here, which is pretty common for aggro tries as well, so can't really blame him. And, yeah, not a fun place to be is position 4 Nyx Assassin. Doesn't do a whole lot. I mean, it's not too bad if you have that poor man shield we'll see them get sometimes, kind of like a Monkey King's run in the 4 roll. You can just trade forever because the damage block and the HP regen, but... like, they just... I don't know, they're throwing everything at the slider, and he's not even, like, not concerned.
He's, I have boots, you can't really kill me. Maybe in a couple of levels when they have Purifying Flames from Winter G, but... as of right now, they will zone out Adam. 3-4-3. But he's regenning up with the Tangos. Looking at the late matchup, 8 last hits for the Tinker, 6 for Mushi. So, relatively even start for the most part. Top lane, BYB is kind of bullying out the Darkseid, but they're both getting farm. Kimmywell taking a lot of damage, almost going down.
Yeah, you can tell Wen's done this matchup before.
Yeah, he seems pretty happy.
He's like timing those iron shells perfectly where finds one on the other side. And, oh my goodness.
Damn it.
It's Nyx Assassin. He's dead.
He's dead. I don't know why he stayed there. They must have think. Oh, they didn't know there was a ward here, so he just was able to like Shadow Wave to the, I don't know, or something happened. So they just did not expect the ward to be there. They finally de-ward it, but... unfortunately, because it does give them first blood. Good stuff for Mineski, though. So already this Nyx Assassin getting killed and not really providing the most for them. All right, man.
Sneaky ward works out. Pays off, that's for sure.
Yep.
But, yeah, again, top lane. Pretty good stuff here by our Darkseer. Forces the Shrine out relatively early on. And it's difficult for the Axe. Like, once this gets to level 3, Iron Shell 2... you'll have to get really lucky on the spins to try and clear the wave out as fast as possible. If Wen can manage to time up like a double iron shell on you, could be in trouble. So,
won't
and
be
Wen
fun.
Even gonna get the pull off here too. But definitely one of the more boring lanes.
Yeah, like nobody should die up here.
Both heroes just kind of kill the wave.
I mean, BYB, he doesn't go for call. He goes for instead the 1 point of battle hunger. He does finally get it now, so maybe he can get something going. Getting run out. The call is there. Spins. No procs. Finally gets one, but one is able to surge himself out, so he should be okay.
Yeah, there's the risk of this lane, too, though. You know, either of these guys could try a man-up play, and you know, obviously the Darkseer would be like, yeah, my Anshell's going to kill you, but it's just a matter of how many spins you get first.
Yeah, it's the RNG, the risk factor. Battle Hunger was used up pretty heavily, but the Darkseer is going to salve himself away. Down bottom, Adam kind of pressing forward here, pushing himself across the river, but decides not to go for anything.
Mushi mid.
Looking
for
James,
well here,
but cannot find him. Refraction was up, Psyblades too. Instead, I'll take a couple of tower hits, but James is going to get pretty low. Down bottom. Uh-oh. Lifestealer in trouble. That's a good fortune's end. One more auto attack should do it, and it will. Ninja Boogie comes in. They find Listener Crush. Good. Nyx and Pale, but Winter G still in a lot of trouble here. Purifying Flames. And they'll give Ninja Boogie the double kill. He uses it on himself, maybe just to try and heal himself back up, but he's not as successful in doing so. And 2 quick kills in this bottom lane, so already this defensive trial is not going well. They find this with a request onto Kimmywell, but Adam just trying to hightail it out of there. Illusion. But stopping this lifestealer from farming, very good stuff here. And Bimbo continues to farm very well.
Oh. Ours. I feel like this is kind of why we stopped seeing Oracle too, is that people would always just dodge him if he was countering, especially Darkseer. Like, almost every single time he would just get dodged. So you'd send the Darkseer safe lane, you'd just aggro with your heroes, especially if you saw the Oracle early enough on in the draft. And he just, you know, he got that nerf to his damage too. So now he hits for 44 at level 2. It's pretty weak.
God, that is not good.
Like look at this dazzle. For 70.
Yeah, he's feeling pretty good. Well, he does have the Lunar Blessing to help out, but still,
I mean, that's true.
You're right.
But even 56, still pretty nice.
Yeah, it's not bad at all. And they will blow up this aggressive trial line. I think they know that Attic can put some effective use elsewhere. They don't need him bottom. Luda can find farm just easily. I don't know, man. Kimmywell doesn't seem like he's doing that much. He's level 2 Nyx Assassin. He's not really getting anything done. He's got a couple of impales on that he's hitting, but
other than that,
they're going to go for the Axe. The Living Crush will come out, surge forward from Wen. Iron Shell should be up. Finally it is, but too little too late.
Oh, he has no mana, guys. Go.
Looks like he might be able to get PYB. Adam looking for another Living Crush. Misses wildly. Spike Carapace will go. Impale up onto Adam. Culling Blade is there in time, and so just a little bit of a too aggressive play coming out from Mineski. One will try to surge himself. Kimmywell had another impale on 4, but didn't have the mana for it. So that aggressive play does not work out, and the Axe gets fed a kill. He'll head back home up to 1,000 gold now. Not a bad play at all for Execration, but for Mineski getting just a bit too aggressive there.
Yeah, that's not exactly the easiest support to make that rotation with either on the Knicks. With the, you know, no setup into the stuns. So very nicely played by
Kimmel. Baller play by Kimmel, indeed.
That could have been pretty bad.
Well, I like how I just talked about it, and he's just like, yeah, let me just show you what I can do. This easy rotation. I was very concerned about his progression on the Knicks assassin, but he seems beautiful.
Oh, yeah, and you should be. I mean, when you're throwing this kind of support role, he can run into some trouble, but he's got a decent couple counters this game. Mostly the Darkseer and playing off the Iron Shell with the Carapace and whatnot.
Using the Spike Carapace, but the Slithering Crush will go.
Oh, this is
risky. Kimuel vacuum back, but when can he get Calling Blade? And BYOB chasing him down. The Surge is there. Adam has another Slithering Crush. He will use it, and so he'll keep Wen alive. There's the Fortune Zed coming out. They want him instead. They have the call, but he is still pretty speedy. His sprint wasn't even on, but he's still pretty fast without it. Coming around, though, here comes James. Laser heat seeking missile combination. See you later. So they won't give it to the Axe, but they still will get the kill and the turnaround, and Wen will fall for 23 seconds.
That takes us to 7 minutes in with a nice stack here on the Ancients. Mushi can be very happy with that.
Oh,
thanks
geez,
to Ninja
wow.
Boogie.
That is something, you're right.
Oh, and then Mushi's stacking the bottom ones too. Damn, all right, Mushi, this is sick.
This is going to be some big efficiency. He is about to just go crazy. Oh, Kimuel, they find Bimbo down bottom. He's just a little too far up. He probably shouldn't be there when he has no supports in lane, but a bit of a misplay coming out.
Yeah, looks like just the old open wounds. Ran on into the stun, but that's okay. Ancients are more important right now. Axe, very rich. Yeah, richest man on the map. Not too shocking, I guess. He got that kill, and he just had a couple stacks in the jungle that were ready for him, too.
He's very close.
So he's going to have his Blink Dagger very fast.
Yeah.
And that should give that space over to Kimuel that we were looking for. So everything looking like it's going pretty well according to Plan for Execration here, honestly.
Mm-hmm.
Considering they got aggro tri-lanes and how frustrating that was and how difficult the two supports had it in the first, like, 5 minutes or so. It was good.
Any stacks for this Tinker? Looks as if that answer to that question is no. He went for Soul Ring, so he is gonna take a bit for him to get his boots to travel, but he will inevitably get them. Mushi cleared out the majority of this stack. He's got to bottle up after he gets that bounty rune. I mean, you have to know this is happening, but what can you do about it for Execration? It's not like you can invade the jungle and potentially... I mean, maybe if they get the Blink Dagger for the Axe, but they don't seem too concerned.
That's the one thing you could do, but... and they know what's happening, as you said. Like, there's a Slardar sitting mid. Like, what the hell else?
I wonder
the
where the TA is, guys. Where
so
could
weird.
He be?
I like this Mushi, the risky plays. But he's got refraction.
You
got
to go for it, man. You got to go for it. 1,300 gold now. Oh, even get the medium camp of the way out. Come on now. He's living dangerously, let me tell you.
Yeah, this is where you get into it. This, anyone shows up here, you are in trouble.
Oh, you're dead. It's just
he's
that,
fine.
He's, yeah. Man, if Axe had his Blink Dagger a minute earlier.
Oh, and the stack. Oh, the efficiency.
Did he get the stack too?
Mm.
That's actually.
Coming.
Come on. Yes. Perfect. Mushi being very efficient, getting a lot of farm. They still have this top ancient stack, too. Look at this thing. It's like a quadruple stack. Something like that. Blink, call. They find Adam mid lane. The March will come out. He's seeking missiles, laser, calling blade. Slithering Crush comes out in time, but he still will fall as he has this battle hunger on him as well. The March still hitting him up, and James will find himself a kill. So, very good setup, and it's a Blink Dagger reveal, which gets James up to about 1,600 and in total gold right now.
Okay, so we'll have our bots up soon. You can rotate around. Keep finding this axe, and that means the first blink rotation, don't even need your life stealer. So Mighty Saver just keeps on farming. Now he's got an Iron Talon, probably just because of how weak that beginning tri lane was, and just using that maybe to farm in the jungle a little bit while you're watching elsewhere or something, but general just helping in lane. So he has the glove. We'll see if he actually finishes out with the armlet. I don't know, could see him considering the Midas, I'm sure.
That's the thing. I've seen a lot of armlet firsts recently, whereas, you know, maybe a week ago, Trent, it was all Midas's for a long time. And it still might be, too. Seems less common now as it was maybe a week ago.
I would say I would like the armlet first this game, just because I think the more pressure you guys apply now, the less likely it is that Mineski's going to snowball with this TA Luna, and then therefore, the better chance you're going to have defending high ground and all that stuff. But Dire, they clearly see this axe. Not exactly an issue, thanks to this ward here, spotting his rotations all through there.
Yeah.
Not Meanwhile, getting too much done right now.
Ooh, smoke up from Adam as well as Mushi. Tread's done. 600 gold in the bank. They're going to head top, look for TP rotation, and maybe come defend this tier 1 tower, but it might just go down. I'd be surprised to see them rotate in right now. Yeah, this tower is just dead. They're instead going to wrap around and go towards mid. Do they have a ward on Adam? Yes, they do. They drop it. in a very aggressive spot. They don't put it behind the tower, which I thought they might have. Maybe they don't want to be too risky about it. Instead, Adam will place it up onto the Ubercliff there. And they will take the Ancients. Which says, thank you very much. I would love it if I could have that, but...
Man, this party ain't stopping.
No.
It's still Luna, so yeah, they'll force up the rotation. There we go. It is the bots. So, not too bad.
Yeah.
They only lose one tower. Before that bots are up.
Yeah, this is where it gets pretty... A little difficult, I'd say. Blink call. They're going to come in. They found Adam. And Pale will fly out as well. Side traps to go. Culling Blade should be there. Then they will use it. They also have the TP coming in from the Tinker, but Mushu does bring down the range creep as he's TPing onto it. Meanwhile, Fortress end down bottom. One is going to get pushed back a little bit. Mighty Savior is here, but the Axe isn't, and they need some sort of lockdown, even with Winter G. But Fortune's End is still on cooldown for 5 seconds. So a couple of big kills coming out here for Execration and some very good farm for some of their cores too, Trent.
Yeah, this will be interesting too, just like the way Wen's playing right now, because he knows his Oracle's here. So typically as a Darkseer, you just want to keep throwing Ion Shells and trying to pressure the wave. And try and hold back. Basically, like, you don't want Lifesteal to just be able to pressure this tower nonstop all by himself. So the fact that he's keeping Oracle down here is pretty good. Can't rotate around. Actually does a lot of damage early on with Purifying Flames. I mean,
yeah.
Looking at 270 nuke, which is very handy when Axe is trying to, like, finish people off. You can just Purifying Flames, Culling Blade, and that's, like, an instant 500 damage, so. Not too shabby. Like, it's annoying that your Iron Shells keep getting purged, but... Oh, and that's also why he's the Iron Town too, because people used to do this quite a bit as well, where you just, you know, if you have a carry that's having a difficult time dealing with the Iron Shells, you can just Iron Shell, rather Iron Town it, and take it down, so.
Yeah, but that's actually a very good point. They have the Infest Bomb in 15 seconds, but BYB might just come in anyway.
Yeah, it looked like my Saber's like looking for it, and he's like, oh, right, I don't have that yet.
It's on cooldown. I'll see you in like 10 seconds, dude, come back. He'll be ready to go momentarily. Vision-wise, they... I think saw the axe, potentially. No, I don't think they did, actually. They didn't see it. The creep wave wasn't there yet. A line being drawn.
Everybody down here.
They're like, they could be at Roche. They're not.
Oh, they just saw those two. The Nyx and the Oracle.
With the creeps coming in? Yeah. So yeah. They probably won't be too aggressive here if you're winning.
Now, Dad's just backing up. Like, I think they're about to jump you, so I'm just going to chill here with Grave. It's only level one, though, so don't hate me if I miss. But we might be able to force their initiation.
Also, if an axe is here, look out.
Yeah,
they smoke up, and I was so close to breaking that smoke. Mushi almost broke it, and then he's like, let's not go up there. Instead, they're looking for Adam mid, but he already sprints himself
not
away.
Again.
Blink call comes out. He's like, please. This has happened 3 times now.
Dude, he's just tanking these ganks for his TA and his Luna. Who cares?
He's like, I'll never get a blink, but don't worry, guys. Everyone else will be farmed. And he actually is kind of close to blink, too.
Yeah, he's doing really well.
Uh-oh. Bimbo, get out of there. Oh, he's fine. Easy TP. He was a half second too late.
Easy.
Easy TP. Quote, unquote, easy. Not quite. They're pushing bottom now. T1 tower is about to fall. A couple TP's been, however, though it looks like they're going to try to have a fight here. He's taking missiles on Dwen. Mushu will finish up this tower, get the last hit on it. Back to mid we go. James as well as Mighty Savior. James will TP out. Mighty Savior here alone. He has his armlet. He wants to finish his T1 tower. You can tell. Weave coming in, vacuum back. He's like, I need to leave. And he will do so.
Oh.
And tower
take
is,
that down so bad.
Oh, man. 5 HP. I thought it was in deny range. It's very close, though.
Looking well. He's scouting. And look who it is. It's Adam.
Yep.
He's too fast.
See you later. Uh-oh.
She's just taking that farm.
Yeah, give me that CS. It's not yours. All right, so still a relatively even game. There's a 2,000 net worth advantage for Maneski, all things considered. That's pretty great. Experience-wise, it is in the Execration favor.
Oh, nice find, that sentry. The Crows of Haze on the Nyx, they can watch him for a little while. And they don't have the best tower pressure, but they do have good tower defense. Tinker starts considering a rotation down bottom.
Oh, he's going to get that T1 mid, finally. It took him a while, but he got there. James is going to march out the bottom wave. Still a fair bit of damage done to this tier 2 tower. 500 or so damage. BYB sitting in the tree line. Adam does not see him. Adam is like, I just want my blink, guys. I'm so close. There's no way that he's up here, right? But actually, Adam's being very cautious. No, don't go for it, Adam. It's not worth it. They can't really go for this kill because it's just the axe. I'd be surprised. Meanwhile, elsewhere, they found Bimbo. They jump in the Infest Bomb. They don't have the axe. Vacuum Wall into the Eclipse coming out as well. James nice. Will fall. Mighty Savior still alive and healthy, but they do get two as Bimbo gets himself a double kill. Can he make Luna. It out? He's got the Yasha move speed, and Mighty Savior gets Lucid Beam now. Melt Strike comes through, and Mushi helps clean up as Bimbo starts it off. They take three down. What a turnaround there. Now the play call comes out. Blade Mail's there. Where are the spins? Finally, he gets one, but Adam sprints himself away. The Battle Hunger is still up. BYB has a blink in three, but Adam jukes to the south, will TP home, and will be successful in staying alive. Oh, it's a disastrous turn of events here for the Radiant, Trent.
Yeah, it really is.
Oh, all right, let me just go mid then.
Fast.
Where are the spins? Finally, he gets them. It took forever. God. He's not had the best RNG this game, let me tell you. Anyway.
Well, that fight, not good. I mean, this is the time of the game where you kind of expect TA and Luna to be a little scary. Maybe a little bit earlier than one might suspect, though. Luna kind of has that, like, up, down, up sort of a cycle where she's, like, super strong in lane because of her aura, and then she kind of needs a little bit of time as she works towards the higher levels in her bouncing glaives, and then... She comes back with all these crazy items. BKB, Butterfly, looks like a Hurricane Pike this game. Potentially coming here for Bimbo. So he's a little bit ahead of schedule, I would say. He's only 200 gold behind a TA that was farming like quintuple ancient stacks.
This TA almost has Desolator, like very close.
And then we get Roche. We give that to, it could be either Bimbo or Mushi, but probably Mushi, I would guess. He just wants to be mega aggressive. But and then we just go. Like, we have a mech, we have a Dazzle. And then the Blink Dagger from Adam is also going to be perfectly timed with this. So everything's lining up for that exact kind of, all right, everyone five man, Roche, let's win this game. Try and take so much control over this game that it's very difficult for you to do anything about it.
I mean, are you dodging fights here for your execration? Do you not want to go toe-to-toe with Mineski?
I mean, if you could try and find a pickoff right now, I think that would be super strong. You definitely want to try and control up Roche and deny up any vision they have into it. So maybe come and try and sentry away the traps that you know TA is going to have. But BYB, that's a lot of heroes.
Bimbo, they had the spins, but they didn't believe. They actually used the Calling Blade, but it was too early. And looks like he'll go down because of it. So James just gets himself out of there. He's like, I don't want to go down too. It's not worth it. And
he must have just missed it or something.
Yeah, I think he did. I came up there and he got two quick spins. I don't know what happened. Maybe there was a shadow wave, I'm not sure. But Bimbo's still alive. And Calling Blade is down for a little bit. So too is the axe, and guess what? This Roche is dead. Corrosive Haze along with the Mushi Desolator and Melt Strike means easily done. And James comes in, throws out some heat seeking missiles, and then says, okay, well, I can't do anything else about that. So it is time now, Trent. It's Mineski's time to go. If they want to try knocking some of these towers down or taking a fight or two, they certainly can.
Oh, man. And then Wen's going to have that next item for him as well. That could mean finishing up the Greaves. But just even getting a Blink Dagger will be very strong for them.
Mighty Savior pretty speedy. Mushi's still chasing. Blink back up in five. It looks like he's just going to push this wave in. Mighty Savior TP's home. Kimuel actually was on a trap and then TP'd himself out. It looks like he decided not to go for Kimuel on the tree line, but... whatever. I think he's perfectly fine just keeping the wave pushed out bottom. Top lane, James is marching it up, trying to get this tier 1 tower knocked down as he wants maybe some TP's forced home as this mid push is starting to occur, I guess you could say.
Yeah, it would be nice to get this tower knocked down, and this next wave is going to do quite a bit of damage to it, in fact.
Vendetta coming out. Let's see if they have any vision here. No sentries that I can see. There's really no detection right now. They have dust. That's it, though. On the back lines, they found Mushi. Sentry comes out. Melt Strike. Jump in. Good counter initiation, though. But still, the Calling Blade brings him down. It's one dead. Mighty Sleeper still trying to leave. Winter G, they're somehow still alive. The False Promise helps out perfectly. And they'll push everybody back now that Adam is dead. BYB wants to reinitiate again. He's got Blink ready to go. Eclipse, though, he blinks up to the high ground. BYB drops up the Blade Mail. The counter helix, the Calling Blade, is not there in time. They can't get the kill. Bimbo was so close to going down there, but narrowly just gets the kill. That was dangerous as all hell, let me tell you. Jesus.
Well, it did look kind of good, at least just getting the one pick on the slider, but then you lose your axe again, so evens out. But Tinker did get that tower top. Just creeps on their own do so much damage. It is absurd.
Mm-hmm.
With all these changes now and whatnot to towers and armor and wobbly blah blah, but you leave a wave on your tower like that for 5 seconds, and you lose like 20%. Blobbity blah
blah. Blobbity blah blah.
That's my
another Trent Pack special.
7.00.
Zip it in a zopping, if you will. Yeah. Really, we do need a compilation. I know I'm poking fun at you, but it's always great. Just to, it's early in the morning.
Nobody cares.
I feel,
man.
Blink, Slithering Crush, Melt Strike. Oh, dear Lord. The Rage comes out. The Armor toggle. Can they get the kill? Toggle again. He might actually live. Another toggle. The Psytrap comes out. Mighty Savior is somehow still alive. Mushi feels like he's been cheated. He's like, you've got to be kidding me. Oh, I thought he was dead for sure. Those toggles were beautiful from Mighty Savior, let me tell you.
Damn. That was kind of crazy.
Oh, Kimmywell. Oh, buddy.
Don't do this to us, bro.
He's crawling around.
He's out. Oh. What? They threw down another sentry?
I think so. Something like, well, they had dust on him. They had dust on him.
Oh, they had dust on him. Let's see that.
That was pretty funny. That just slowed to a crawl. Please don't kill me. I have Spike Carapace. Maybe that'll dissuade you. Nope. Right, Dragon guys. Lights up for Luna. And here comes the push, my friend. It's happening.
2 minutes. Just 2 minutes of Aegis, guys. Come on.
We can do it.
Hold out.
No Eclipse for 25 seconds, Mushi. Jamie's going to blink in, march it up. They've got the Centaur Conqueror. Who's got the helm? Is it Wen?
It's Luna.
Luna? I didn't even see that. Well, the Tier 2 tower's gone. March does blow up the creep wave, though. And they're out. Perfectly happy with that. And we'll probably wait for a bit. They might do another sort of initiation with this Aegis still for about 1 minute left. They can go for something, but that seems
to be
kind of
like this Vision bottom. They wanted to take that tower, honestly. They like with the little bit of Aegis they had left.
We'll see if they go for it. They have the Psytrap and the tree line, too. I love the positioning for the Psytrap. So good. He's got a couple around the map. He doesn't have the most, but he's got some good vision coming out for the TA. Very small radius of vision.
So it is a smoke up top. Oh, this Luna illusion. Oh, it's double. I thought maybe it was a single illusion.
If it was a single illusion, that's easy bait. They do. They might find Adam or Bimbo. Obviously, one target is higher value than the other. They seem to know something is up as he forces himself out with a Hurricane Pike, maybe just to try to farm quicker. But
yeah, no, they haven't spotted anyone down bottom. They have this ward down here. It doesn't see anyone rotating through the jungle farming.
There's they have this ward up here too. I don't know. They probably didn't smoke up on top of that ward. I hope anyway. There's the tier two. All right, one more tier two left, Trent. Minuscure knocking him down right now.
They see Lifestealer up here too, but all right, they are gonna go back. I thought maybe they could consider pressuring high ground just to force them all back. But then there's a chase scenario, and it's not really worth giving that up. Might as well just play it safe and defend your tier two top. With Aegis expiring, as there it goes.
Roche respawn in 5 minutes and 14 seconds, so a 10-minute and 20-second Roche respawn time total, which is pretty long, I'd say.
My God, dude, Mushi is rich.
Yeah, 4.5k. He is.
He bought a Void Stone.
Really like saving that money, huh? Did he buy a Void Stone?
He did.
That's interesting.
Why is he buying a Void Stone?
Well, let's think of the options here. Let's go.
I mean,
let's click on
Void
Stone.
He's buying a Scythe.
Is he really?
He's doing it.
Is he actually?
He is. Well, I was trying to think, like, nothing else really makes sense. Like, I was thinking he would want the BKB, honestly.
That's
like,
so weird.
Even though it's kind of bad against Axe for obvious reasons, it is still nice against the Tinker, especially the Blind is always going to be a problem for him. So he's just going to deal with the Blind the old-fashioned way, just
Man.
Kill the Tinker.
What? How many times have you seen Scythe on TA? Never?
No, this is like the Ursa style. He's basically just playing, like, Scythe Ursa right now.
Yeah, that's fair. Kimmy all gets hexed up, and he's like, he is a hex, and I am dead. See you all later. Don't even know if it was necessary, but he is, in fact, dead.
That's where you're, like, looking at TA inventory, and you just ping the scythe, like, 4 times. You're like, guys, he
beware, beware, beware. Oh, BYB. Call comes out. Nimbo. Blink, Slithering Crush, though. Shadowblade is up for Axe. False Promise comes back out. The Vacuum Wall into it. BYB gets Fated Edicts as well, but Winter G might die because of this. He uses the Fortune's End, but I do believe he is probably dead here. Lucid Babe, Slithering Crush, a couple of auto attacks will do the job, and it's a dominating spree for Bimbo. So yes, the Axe to stay alive, but they will lose one hero one way or the other. And now It is time to finish up this next tier 2 tower. Mushi is, by the way, being very cheeky.
The things you can do with a scythe.
Yeah.
Wait. Crush someone.
He's ready to pounce.
It's hyper aggressive, but it's fun.
I was thinking more like a Meepo type thing, but I guess Ursa is probably the better way to describe it. It's like you're playing an Ursa Scythe, yeah. I think that's more accurate for sure.
Well, it is terrifying.
Yeah, it's
that
not
is
fun.
For certain.
If James gets hexed up, I mean, good luck. They can find him anyway. That's the tough part. I imagine though we might see some waiting here for Maneski until the next Rosh is up, and
yeah,
perhaps they go for that and then they get high ground. But now, that will give a couple of items over to Execration, including the Aghanim Scepter for James. He also has the Aetherlands picked up, so he's starting to finally come online. This tanker. Some serious damage can be done with his items. Axe, we already talked about his Shadow Blade. The Lifestealer has his Desolator, but he really hasn't gotten anything since then. He's up to 2,000 gold, and he's working on the AC. This game is still very difficult for them, I think, for this Radiant team.
I'm just taking a look now. It looks like Mushi's been on a bit of a scythe kick. He had a 37-minute scythe the other day on his TA. And this one a little faster. Just slightly, like 11 minutes or so. But,
that's insane. That is actually insane.
He's definitely enjoying the hyper-aggressive style with, like, minimal defensive items. Of course, the other times he's had an Omni Knight, so he's just feeling very bold this time. He's got the Dazzle. He's like, you know what? This is fine. It's kind of like that, like, Storm Spirit idea where you have the mana hero or whatever. What EG always called it, I think, the mana battery or whatever whenever they discuss the hero. But now you just have it's just your saving hero, you know?
Yeah.
Your TA plus your savior. Who needs BKB?
Honestly, need that. I like the lockdown. I really do. It's hard to lock down a Lifestealer.
And against like a Lifestealer too.
Yeah.
Like oh.
Yeah.
Like he's.
And they're
gonna
go for it right now. They've got the hex. It's a creep. That is a
Classic.
Creep. Side trap.
That creep did move it like the last.
Yeah,
second.
He really did. It was tricky. They have the Center Conquer Stomp beautifully done. Slytherin Crush, and they should combo up to get this kill still.
I mean,
Center Conquer Stomp was Ownage, but
clearly intentional.
Uh-oh, Vacuum. James has been spotted. He's like, get me out. Get me out. Iron Shell, Darkseer, run. Sidetrap comes out. They drop the wall as well. Slowed up. Can they bring him down? The Lucid Beam. They have the Hex. They will use it. Can they bring him down? False Promise just in time from the Oracle. Refracted Laser. Adam misses out on this. Slytherin Crush. They've got the Call into two. Where are the Counter Helix Procs? It's not there. The Laser comes through, though, doing some serious damage. They will pop the Eclipse on top of it. They might need a backup, though. The Laser goes again. This time, getting the kill on Ninja Boogie. They all have to back up. That Oracle save was there, and the Tinker. My God, you saw how much damage he did when they turned it around. Jesus, that laser does so much work.
Damn, dude.
Yeah.
Big turnaround. Didn't get Mushi, though, so that's very good for Maneski. That would have been an issue. I thought he was getting a little bit risky there. Now they're just getting aggressive again. Good choice from BYB. He's got the Shadow Blade. Unlikely that Bimbo spots him here.
Call comes out. Laser heat-seeking missile. Spin's not there. Another laser heat-seeking missile. They don't need the calling blade. Mushi jumps and gets the hex just in time. James in trouble. One more auto tech. They'll find the kill. Did not have call. He just gets it now. Blade mill is up there doing some serious damage. And calling blade misses completely. And Mushi will turn it around and turn two. Gets himself a mega kill spree and a double kill. Very big kills coming out. Getting a little bit too aggressive for Execration. And they will lose two important cores and only secure Bimbo.
Oh, that blade mail is so scary. Refraction, still one of the better ways to deal with blade mail. So as long as you have it up when you think Axe is going to initiate or something like that, you can be okay. But still very scary if your refractions are down. He manages to find you. And I guess that kind of harkens back the whole idea of the BKB 2 and just how much protection that's going to give you. Mushi is going to run into troubles dealing with this refraction as this game goes on.
Yeah, it's not easy.
Yeah, it's like, do you buy a Manta? Because he's just going to rearm, so that doesn't really save you.
Yeah. Well, Hurricane Pike is sort of a way to deal with it, but...
Yeah, not too bad. Just get out of the fight when you're in trouble. We'll see how much longer he can go without just the straight-up BKB, honestly.
I think he'll buy
sure
it next.
I'm sure once the Kumail Hex, or rather Aghanim's, comes out, if it ever does, he'll really have no choice.
They will definitely need that BKB. D-Ward's coming out. Wow, that sentry is... It looked like it was further away, I suppose. But they're going to go, and Rosh will take half a second here with Crow's Phase. And... Jesus. And they have a double damage, too. Good stuff. And it's dead. So good stuff. Mushi has the Aegis, too. Puts his Aquila in his backpack. And I would imagine in the next 5 minutes, Trent, we will see some sort of high ground aggression coming out from Maneski here.
Yeah, if you're Execration and trying to stop that, they're just going to have to try and look for a... an initiation somewhere across the map.
Yeah.
If they can find a, if you can pick off one hero at a time, try and get them away from their five-man group up. Might be able to stop that from happening. and then just delay this game out, keep going. There is an AC all of a sudden here from Mighty Savior. Not very far away at all, considering. It's like only 1,300 goldish.
Yeah, they need that item. They need a couple of items, really, but...
All right, Infest ready. No vision, but looks like Darkseer is just like, yeah, no.
He is back. He TB'd into that tier 2, and then he blinked away immediately. He's like, nope.
Dude, those Mantas just actually cleared that whole wave up. Damn.
Pretty
Go Luna. What a hero.
Well, I mean, she's not quite the hero she once was, but she's still pretty freaking good. And when you get to this point especially. See her probably get a butterfly next or something.
We got teams waiting on waves across the map. And no one's coming to either.
There's a lot of patient play here from both teams. Oh, they're definitely going to come and defend this, for sure. Gwen is there. He's like, yeah, that's fine. I'm just backing up. Meanwhile, mid's getting pushed in. James is like, I'll just get farmed this way. I don't know. There's a whole lot of waiting happening right now. Finally, Bimbo and Ninja Boogie will back up, but I don't know.
Well, definitely favors the Radiant. I mean, this is Aegis time.
Yeah. You're making something happen.
It's just sitting in the trees.
He even just goes in and he just uses the meld. It's like, whatever.
His TV's in his backpack, too, so if they actually initiated on down bottom, it would have been a big delay.
They see the axe. They do see the axe. They know the axe is here. But Mushi's more concerned about Mighty Savior, who's about to walk up into the creep wave. Can they go for this?
They put the sentry down. They made sure there was no cliff vision.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, he's coming out.
Oh, Hex comes in. And Silurian Crush on top onto two. That was pretty onage, actually. Dust comes out. They will get the call. Here comes the refracted laser. This should be Aegis now down. Mushi wasn't expecting James to be there as well. Everybody rotate again now. Mushi, refraction is up. Get a Hurricane Pike himself away. He's got Blink in one. They jump in. Call will come out. No, now it does finally. BYB. Here comes the Eclipse as well. They're all pretty grouped up here. Vacuum Wall coming back in as well. And now Bimbo says, listen, I'll take care of it for you, Mushi. Mighty Savior caught out. Blown away. Triple kill for him. Four heroes dead. What a fight. What a easy, great initiation from this Darkseer. They're all clumped up together. He just says, I'll take a vacuum wall. BYB trying to cut the creep wave, though, which is the perfect idea. But he needs to run. He has Blinket, and he could blink into the trees. He doesn't want to stay much longer. And Adam is looking for him, and he won't find him. So,
I'm surprised they stayed around post Aegis. I thought they were going to leave and just let it go, you know? Like... Just let her come back, get out of the rotations. But if you look at the vision, they have nothing in here. Whereas the Dire, they have Obs, they have sentries all throughout this corridor. Yeah,
everywhere.
So, yeah, they knew there was no Radiant vision. They're like, look, they're not going to expect us to come in. They don't know where we are. They probably think we're still on the other side of the map. Let's fight this. And, well, indeed, Execration had no idea what the hell they were up to. So they got owned. And they're still going to lose their Tier 3 here.
Maybe. Impale will come out. Mantle Illusions were just popped up. They should lose their Tier 3, I would imagine. I don't know, maybe not.
Oh, nice, nice.
All right, it says 70 HP, 59 HP. This tier 3 is not dead yet. If Mushi had been there, it would have been dead much quicker, but unfortunately not the case. No. All right, well.
All right. Top lane just became the priority. Keep this pushed out, see if we can hold on to our shrines for the next Rosh.
Yeah, that's the thing, isn't it? Oh, man, they're sitting right around the shrine. They're like, I want to take this so badly. Just go hit it once, Bimbo. Come on, man. Just go hit it once. You have the Alpha Wolf. Send him in. And the Illusions.
Yeah, he could just send his next random Mantis towards it, I'm sure.
He's thinking twice about it. They know that, like you said, that this is the priority for the Radiant team. So if he gets caught up there and dies, and that maybe begins Execration on the comeback trail, and they don't want to have that happen. So they'll play it safe instead. He is going for... I thought he was going for Butterfly, but he's buying Boots of Travel instead. So unless he's got it flying out already, which might be the case.
Oh, he dodges it. He's going. There's the Alpha Wolf and the Illusion. They stunned up.
He tried
to make plays. He tried to split them knowing the axe was coming, but not quite there. All right. Another great defense of the Tier 3 tower. Gets the Horde.
BYB.
Mineski.
Trying to make things a bit safer for his team. He's heading in the opposite direction of where Mineski is.
They have a gem on Adam.
Bottom jungle, but... BYB about to get spotted. Slytherin Crush will come through. Shadow Wave on top. Lucy Beam to follow up as well. Lodestorm comes in, though. And he's going to get slowed up. The False Promise is there. Bimbo pops his BKB. Vacuum back wall again, but blinks out in time somehow. The laser will come out. The Greaves are there.
Mantillusions
go. Go, Mantillusions. It was like, oh, no. The laser comes out. He's so close. Instead, Mushi walks up, auto-attacks at once, says thank you very much. But here we go, Blink Call, they've got the Infest out. Slytherin Crush to counter-initiate, the Impale is there. Can they keep Mushi alive? Vendetta comes out, he will fall. Dead for 83 seconds, was it worth it, Mushi? Adam now getting chased down as well. The missiles, the lasers are there. You want to be looking for the call. Instead, they're going to jump at the Eclipse, and Bimbo is in right now, and it's not going well. He does not have his BKB. The Culling Blade will be there. A bit too aggressive for Mineski, and now Ninja Boogie's going to get caught as well. Might see if he turns himself around. He goes for the TP. They don't have a Basher, and Ninja Boogie will get out somehow. BYB chasing a little too far. Yeah.
He wanted the next target, so good blink there, rather TP there from Ninja Boogie, but... Execration, they are finding the picks they need. That is a negative 1,000 for the for Mineski, and then plus 2,800. So massive swing overall here for Execration.
I believe it is time to get that BKB for Mushi.
I don't know. It is still kind of just like, what does it do? And I don't know, he got locked down and chained down the whole time anyway.
That's true. I don't know. They need something.
You need something, though. Yeah.
Surprised they don't have Lotus Orb or anything yet.
Yeah, I have to say, speaking of which, BYB, his items have just been... He's, like, so on point, not just with his itemization. Even though, it's pretty standard stuff, the Blink, Shadow Blade, Blade Mail, and the Axe, but then going for the Lotus Orb, and he's just always saving that Blade Mail for the right moment, making sure that he can try and blow up Mushi, or in that case, the Eclipse was going down on top of his Blade Mail again. So, he's really doing work here.
All right, so Luna does end up going back for the Butterfly, by the way. He had queued up the Boots of Travel, but it looks like he's just going to finish out the Butterflies. He already had the Eagle Song up and ready, which makes sense. But the BKB is being picked up right now for Mushi. He already has the Ogre Club, and the rest of it's queued up, so I imagine that's going to be coming down the grapevine pretty soon. All right,
well, that gives him like 10 free seconds of sieging if Axe isn't there, so that's pretty sick.
That's the issue.
But again, still just turns a full priority of the squad into finding killing BYB.
Oh, so they're in Crush. They have found James, and boy, is he dead. That's pretty good. Let's see if they can force buyback. Oh, and they're going to get the shrine.
He pings out that there's a ward there, maybe? Or no, that was
where
Mushi.
Did he ping?
Just pinged it.
Where did he ping?
Oh, no, Mushi was just pinging up here, but I don't know.
All right.
They're checking, but there's nothing there. I think the TA trap is what spotted out the Tinker.
Yeah, it definitely did. It was right here, and they just jumped right on top of him. TA trap pretty good. Butterfly now done. BKB pretty close to completion for the TA. They've picked up the shrine, and they're going to try to force a buyback here, and boy, they need to.
They have vision, too.
Glyph is coming off cooldown in 9 seconds. The buyback is there, and they're going to force themselves away. Kimio almost died. He has to vendetta himself away as he almost got dropped by the glaives from Bimbo. He's like, I need to leave. And so they will end up keeping their racks alive, but the buyback being forced by James is pretty problematic if you're Radiant here.
They really need to get this ward down, though. So, yeah, there we'll get some energy, and he'll scope it out. Oh, they've got a gem anyway on the Knicks, so give me a little spot this now. Get himself a little bit of free money.
Give me that. Vendetta 8. Oh, he didn't have it. It was on cooldown. He calling blitted it in the end. But, yeah, next fight might be around Roshan. It's up in about a minute or so, and you can already see... Execration running out of their base. They'll take down the trap. They know that it's been taken down, so there is some vision. Mineski understand there are at least two heroes over in this top jungle, probably everybody. It looks as if they really want to contest this, and it's, again, up in a minute, but it's very tough. Very, very difficult. They do it so quickly, too. If they're late, it's a huge problem. And also, they don't have their shrine top. They're going to lose their shrine bottom. So the map control is slowly dwindling and going in Mineski's favor. Alright.
Picker can't even, like, stay in one spot for too long. He's so scared at this point.
I would be, too. If he gets that Hex, though, man. You know what can happen when a Tinker gets a Hex? The game can change. But
yeah, that would be actually so crazy. He got to manage to pick off Mushi a couple times, too. Just... It is interesting just to see, like, this hero is usually so kind of, like, invincible or whatever on the TA. She just, like, hops in and does everything and... it's a tough game. I mean, there's just so many things up against you. This Axe especially is the number one problem with the Blade Mail, but he takes away your defensive mechanism and having this Dazzle because, like, Ninja Boogie hasn't even graved anyone this game because every single time someone's dying, Axe is right next to them. It's, like, not even a point. He's like, well, might as well just save my mana, guys. It's not going to do anything.
No. It's not easy. Rosh is up and has been scouted by this Psytrap.
DD on Bimbo, too.
Yeah, he got it a good 30 seconds ago, but he should still have about half of it left, and he does. So we'll see if they go for Rosh now. Looks as if that might be the case.
Right. Dire Vision. I see Life Stealer. If Axe shows here. I don't think he will, though, so they'll probably know an Infest is coming.
Smoke comes out.
BYD's telling the ping to push bottom, but the Mantis just clear up the full wave, and now the pressure is just immediately back.
The line has been drawn. Adam is like, let's go. There is nobody on the high ground, but they can still find some initiation in mid if BYB or Camille are not careful. I'm going to walk forward here, potentially. BYB will back up, and so they just missed their timing in terms of finding kills. Honestly, they could take Roche so quickly, I'm just surprised they're not in there first. I guess Mushi doesn't have slots.
Yeah, I think they just knew that it was... They're going to come and contest Roche, so if we're here, they're just going to all die. Like, if we can just sight that axe, we're going to win this fight. So they're waiting for the rotation to come from the Radiant, and now they'll just scan to guarantee it. Radiant scan, and yeah, I mean, they saw Mushi take down the ward, they pinged it. Sure, they knew they had no chance of getting there in time.
Yeah, there is just no way. I mean, Radiant just... It dies so quickly. Mushi just kills it instantly. They have the MKB, by the way, for the Lifestealer. They are really trying to fight this, despite the fact that there is an Aegis. They have seen Mushi. Sidetrap is up. Call will go. They'll find him. They're going to try to jump in. Slurry Crush counter initiation. Back wall. On to four. But where is Bimbo? He's a little too late to the party. The Eclipse will come out. The only one dead so far is Adam. Winter G will fall next, but he's an Oracle, so who cares, really? They jump in. They find the Hex. The Meldstrike. BYB in trouble. He will fall as well. Dead for 85. He does have a buyback. Again, Wen has hit these back wall combos beautifully. And if Bimbo was there a half second earlier, that's an easy, easy pickoff. And probably majority, like most of the team, just dead. But that's not the case.
Uh-oh. Yeah, just a desperation maneuver from Execration.
Yeah, it is pretty desperate at this point. And Pale will come out. Can you also spike Carapace? And there's going to be the cheese used. And Mighty Savior going toe-to-toe with Mushu as Aegis, by the way. Vivax will come out from the axe, vacuum back in. Hex will come through. They found Mighty Savior, but it looks like you might have to leave here if you're Mineski. Impale will miss. The Hex is still up, though. They will find the kill onto the Darkseer, and they will blow up Bimbo as well. Mushi now on the run. All of a sudden, they've gotten too aggressive here. Great buyback. BYB still chasing Mushi, trying to dodge to the tree line. Meldstrike, he wants to be able to spike Carapace up. They've got the call, and they get the Aegis. And this time, there's not heroes to save him on Mineski's side. They're going to go again. Blinks away. The Hex is already up and ready to go. Open wounds as well. Blink call. Calling Blade. See you later. Mushi now dead for 90. Oh, that is... And they did not get anywhere near getting this full set of racks down, Trent. Wow. What a huge fight.
Glaives didn't even get to do too much work to the range rack, so the melees will once again regen up. And despite a rather disastrous defense near the Ancients, that one worked out superbly well. The high ground is scary. They got caught once again. I couldn't believe how fast that Luna went down, but... Just a BKB, I guess, maybe. Well, oh, it was probably used during that eclipse when she was running in onto the three-man wall. So she didn't have the BKB, so.
Yeah, I think so.
Smart there from Execration, knowing that TA and Luna had already popped them. So even though it's kind of scary to just fight them right again, they didn't really have a choice.
We may see some buybacks here. We may have to see some buybacks. Bimbo shouldn't need to, but they are at least going to lose their tier 3 tower. Can you imagine if they lost Rax first? It might actually happen.
That's
tier 3
tough.
Back.
I know, that march is pretty deep. Mushi doesn't seem inclined to buy back when he's coming up with the blink.
Yeah, this is Rax. At least melee, and they're going to infest out now.
They're not even going to get
the
vacuum.
They buy back. They're going to vacuum back, and Slithering Crush comes out as well. They have the infest bomb ready. Already Bimbo doing some good work with the glaives. They get the Hex off. There's the False Promise coming in. BYB somehow still alive. They get the stun of Winter G. They have the Gross Phase up as well. The good blink away from BYB still alive. How is nobody dead yet? They will finally get the Oracle and the Axe dead for 2 minutes, and James will be next. Now down for 90. They will lose Adam. They're going to try to turn it, but Mighty Saver, the only survivor now, as Mushi pops the BKB. Yes, they will lose their melee racks, but there are heroes dead for a very long amount of time, and Mighty Saver is the only one. And so I think now it looks like Mineski will just go push mid and try to get into that top lane as well. And this is looking pretty disastrous after that fight, man. Let me tell you.
Yeah, that was some risky business to stick around.
How long does Tinker? Oh, Tinker's got buyback in 9 seconds, so it is only the axe.
Oh, that is good. Maybe that'll. I don't know. I feel
is
like
it gonna be
gonna
enough?
The racks.
They really need this axe, to be fair, and he's not anywhere close to buyback. Spike Carapace will come out. Bimbo.
Oh, that
they've
was
got
nice.
The hex. They've got the missiles. Lotus Orb vacuum is there. They continue to hex him up. They've got the grave, but without axe, they can't use the calling blade. Heat-seeking missiles will fly. He's going to get healed up with a Shadow Wave, and they will back up. Man, even without the axe, the control is there for Execration to bring him down. And Bimbo is just like, that's a bit of nope. I'm getting out of here. See you later.
That is not exactly the kind of interactions you think of at the start of the game, but in terms of an Ix-Assassin sitting way back here when you're trying to siege, uncontrollable. And he just carapaces you, and they close the gap. Level 4 is a long time. Like, yeah. 2.4 seconds is a very decent stun.
It's like he almost has to be KB just to just do some damage onto the Rax. I mean, he has a lot more survivability now that he's a Satanic, but it's still hard. You know, what is his BKB down to? 6 seconds? So, all right.
Yeah. Mushi's still holding 8 here, and Axe, 13 more seconds.
He's up soon. This game has gotten a lot closer. I mean, it was looking, I don't want to say pretty in the bag for Mineski, but it was looking hard for Execration to come back. And so far, it is now about a 7,000 deficit in terms of net worth for Execration, which at 46 minutes into the game is not a lot. That's maybe one or two team fights.
No, especially when you were down 15K.
So. Yeah, yeah, exactly. They've done pretty well here. James finding the right initiation. BYB, as you had mentioned, one of the outstanding players here for Execration in this game.
Working on the Shiva's a while. Sure, he knows he needs buyback, though, so 250. Yeah. That's a little bit of a tough call. It's like, do I just buy it and try and win a fight? I think he'll probably just hold for buyback. He's so crucial for killing Mushi.
Yeah, we'll see. Next Roche is still a ways away, and that seems to be what this game has been revolved around for the most part. Finding Aegis and Cheese and trying to make something happen with it. But Shiva's guard picked up for the Axe.
All right, risky. So really needs to get some kills going here.
Yeah, Basher almost Abyssal up for the Lifestealer, and if you can get that, they have even more lockdown, which they're not lacking. They have a lot of it, especially when there's no BKB. But here again, Mineski encroaching upon the enemy territory, looking for something. They will just deward. That has really been the problem here for Execration, is they've been kind of hemmed in this region of the map. They really can't go any further than that.
Yeah, it's one of those games you're very happy you at least do have this, like, Tinker, Ember, Alchemist kind of a hero. So you have someone who's still pushing out these waves to a decent pace, just saving your buildings. Like, there's still no pressure on either of these lanes, really. I mean, mid tower's taking some damage, but bottom lane's still full HP.
The fact that top Rax has survived this long kind of speaks volumes about the draft for Execration and how well they've played it, too.
Kind of knowing what to expect from Mineski.
All right, man. What are we going to see? When's the action happening? Is it around Roche? Are Mineski going to make a play before that? What's the dealio?
I could see Execration maybe making a play out to try and find some vision and stuff before the Roche is up. Like, I think Execration are kind of at that point where they're like, they know that Mineski are waiting for Roche. They're never going to come high ground. You could smoke out and try and get some vision down, but it's going to be risky.
It's not easy, for sure.
Oh, they're doing it.
Yeah.
I think. G's got the smoke.
They have the smoke on them? Here we go. Get over there, James. Actually, he's got bots. It's probably fine. Does he have bots,
he's got
too?
Bots, too.
Yeah, he has bots, too. All right. It's coming right in. All right,
so pretty split here. Oh, Adam is not the hero.
No. Courier.
He's a Shadowblade. They're going to
Bimbo. Call. That's the hero. Shiva's guard. Do they get him in time? I believe they did. The Vendetta Impale coming out as well. They've got the Hex. The lasers there. Ninja Boogie getting bashed up. He's down. Two dead immediately. And it is time to leave for Mineski. And they might have to force out another buyback here. This time it's Bimbo dead for 88 seconds. Okay. And they're going straight for the shrine. They're like, I don't care. Let's get some map control back. We have a gem. We can get some wards down.
Oh, it's a 2-minute Roche. So
that's rough.
Not going to help
that
them.
Is so rough. Man, the RNG is not with them this game, let me tell you.
No, that would be pretty wild. Like, when did you just walked in here and there was a Roche?
Hey, guys.
They would just be like, what?
No, they're not so fortunate. Instead, they'll have to do it the hard way. Adam's sitting on the high ground on his perch, ready to initiate.
Yo, BYB's
he's going in. Do they have the gems? Lure Crush comes out. The Hex is there. He needs some help. Hurricane Pike to come out as well. And BYB getting bombs lobbed. But he is so tanky with that Shiva's guard. They only do half of his HP pool. Damn. And they find Wen.
What?
Shiva's guard will go. He's caught out. Was looking for the rune. Fortune Den is there. And he's going to get dropped down too. So he's dead for 88. Luckily enough for him, he does have buyback. They'll take the second shrine now down bottom. Kimwiwall Sidetrap is up. He's trying to run. It looks like he should be able to make it away. He just Vendetta's out. Courier trying to deliver something. His Quelling Blade, it looks like. That was weird.
Oh, they have the another gem on there, too. They have the Ninja Boogie gem.
Bots in. Jump in, Adam impaled up. The Hex is there. Blink away immediately. Kimuel might have to give his life for this. Gem is now down in the deck. They're going to have to try to bring him down. They blow him away immediately. Ninja Boogie gets caught. He is blinking like crazy. James is somehow out of here. He should have gotten caught two or three times there. And now they need to leave. Mushi melded up. Do they have the detection? Who has the gem? Somebody picked
the
it up.
Had it.
Yeah, he dropped it, though. Did they pick it up?
No, the Dire God, I think.
Yeah,
Adam.
I think Adam got it and left. I don't know. He must have dropped it somewhere. Oh. Oracle has the gem.
Thanks, okay. Medeski.
Yeah, Medeski just owned it. They just owned us. And they still don't see Mushi, though, even with the gem.
Yeah, Adam had a gem anyway, so damn. Just around that tree line.
Oh, Roche is not up. Still. Again, not such an easy game. Poor execration that Roche would be up there. But, man, I know you were watching Ninja Boogie getting crushed. I think you probably saw him get absolutely destroyed. But James had, like, two or three insane rearm blinks that were just, like, he should have died.
Yeah, the first one. I saw the first one. I had no idea how. Like, Mushi just could not get the right-click off in time. Like, just physically, I'm just not even sure how that's possible. He just, like, blinked and right-clicked, and the Tinker was gone. And I was like, all right.
Yeah.
Insane timing on the re-
Imagine that, but, like, two more of those. Like, it was insane. I don't know how he did it. He somehow stayed alive. The Abyssal is just about done here for Lifestealer. He's trying to save her buyback and Abyssal. And I think he has enough for it, too, or at least he's very close. BYB is going to head into the Roche pit.
Really close.
Oh, this is difficult. There is the side trap in the Roche pit, so if they head in there, then I don't think they kill this nearly fast enough when you have they would need something like Corrosive Haze, which is how they do it so quickly on Mineski's team.
Yeah, and it's not that early in the game anymore, but they can come in. They should have Oracle in there. I don't know. When did G's come in? Like, oh, yeah,
this is mega dangerous. They're going to back up. BYB's like, let's go. Again, they still have that gem,
oh,
I believe, on Adam.
On the high ground. They see
Blink them. Call comes out onto two. The counter helix is there. The impale comes out as well. They've got the coin blade. They'll use it not once. They won't use it at the second time. It looks like they won't get it off the second time, but still they will get the third kill. Kimuel comes in, finds Adam. Gem in the deck. That was insane. That Observer Ward helped out so much.
I can't believe that ward just sat there. I think Adam was just too far out.
I don't know where Adam was.
He couldn't see the ward because he had the gem on him on the slider and then lost it in that fight. But
yeah.
My God, what a ward. Game-winning ward, man. You see this Luna and Dex here right next to each other. This is Axe, and you're like, oh my God.
You were talking about the calls for the Axe and the draft, and that's exactly the big call they needed. BYB is really... He's putting his team on his back with some of these plays that he's making, honestly. It's a full team effort, don't be wrong. Don't get me wrong, but, like, it's still insane how well he's playing. It's pretty nifty.
Damn. All right.
Well, Aegis and Cheese, and finally, they're able to get out of the base. Clear out some of these group waves. James has some breathing room to work with now. Net worth is still in favor of the Dire, but it is climbing ever so close back to zero. It is now 5,000 instead of the 7,500 we talked about earlier. And it will only get worse as they take down the Tier 2 tower. Buybacks probably won't be forced here, but they will apply some pressure into this Tier 3 tower top lane. As Mighty Savior walks up, he has Aegis. He's got his Abyssal Blade ready. His armlet is inside of his backpack. They get the Hex off onto BYB, but blink in. Kimuel, nicely done for Mushi to get out in time. Very good blink. The glyph will go. Mighty Saber will finish off the Tier 3 tower and look for the Rax as well.
All right, he's in.
Yeah. Slurring Crush to come out again. He does have Aegis. Vac wall coming through. Already a pretty good fight. False Promise is there. That's on James. They get the impale off. Blink call on to three. BYB misses the calling blade, but still doing a lot of damage to Bimbo. He does have the Satanic. He will pop him, but it gets hexed up again. The Shiva's guard. He survives a second longer, but he will fall. He is forced to buy back. They did lose the Aegis, mind you. Yule Scepter coming out, Ninja Boogie solo, Melt Strike coming in. Slytherin Crush will find BYB. He is getting caught. He's got the cheese. Can he get it off? Yes. Forced away by Kimuel. Somehow still alive. Gets Fate Edict as well. They will pop the Eclipse coming out. Winter G trying to run. Uses the Ghost Scepter. The Fractal Laser doing some serious work. They're coming back in. The Hex is up. Bimbo needs to leave. The Impale comes out. He gets Abyssal as well. Forced away one more time. Adam gets off a great Slytherin Crush. They get off the False Promise, though, onto BYB. Mighty Savior will take down Ninja Boogie. Mushi now getting choked down. Mighty Savior looking to fight. Abyssal Blade not up. Now Slytherin Crush comes out. Uh-oh, Mighty Savior might be in trouble. Lotus Orb, there's gems on the deck everywhere. Mushi getting open wounded, but there's the Hurricane Pike away as well. They're still staying. They still want to fight this. They find the hex. They get the call. It's Onditu. Oh, no, Wen actually avoided it. He got the vacuum up, but will still get calling bladed down. He is dead for 2 minutes, and Mushi might be next. The hex is there. Can they break the refraction? The force away. He's about to fall dead for 100 seconds. He's got buyback. Call will come through, but if Bimbo dies here, it might be game. Mighty Savior gets the Abyssal Blade off. He's getting lower and lower. Flutter, they missed the Calling Blade. He might actually turn around, but he still will fall. One more counter. Helix proc does the job. And now Mushi trying to go toe-to-toe. Mighty Savior going to work. Mushi will fall. Everybody dead. GG is called. What a man fight to end this game. Holy shit. I can't believe they did it.
God damn. BYB, ladies and gentlemen, a fantastic Axe Pawns, my god. And that last fight too, when he did miss that one call, and Dazzle finally had a chance, we saw some Graves come out, but at this point in the game, there's just so much damage flying out from the Tinker and the Rockets that it's so difficult to even sneak away from the fight at low HP and try and get healed back up. Things are flying over. That Shiva's Guard did an unbelievable amount of work from the Axe in the late game. Like, picking that up, definitely the right call, and again, just his itemization, I would say, flawless this game. Wow, that's a hell of a way to start a best of three.
What a game, man. What a game. Look at the graph. Team XP and net worth all the way down to the bottom, and then boom, shoots right back up at the end there, and the net worth just skyrockets for Execration. What a turnaround. You mentioned some of the top players here for Execration, and they will help secure that victory. So game one will go to Execration. Game two is right around the corner. Remember, it is a best of three, so Mineski have one more chance to even the series up and take it to that third game. Thank you so much for joining us here today on Moonduck. My name is Mont. With me is Trent Pax. We'll be back with game number two in just a moment.